So I kind of cheated. I made dough a little bit earlier. It's basically just putting water and warm water and yeast, activating the yeast and water. Put in a little bit of flour to get it started because yeast needs carbohydrates. And then put in a little bit of oil, salt, and then knead the flour. So now we got the dough. It's been rising for 2 hours and we're just gonna knead it a little bit more so it's pliable and workable. Kneading is an art, and what it does is it creates gluten, so your pizza dough will stick together. What you want to do is not get the dough too dry. And it's stretchable, and if you can like stretch it without breaking it like that, then that means that means it's a little, you can add a little bit more flour to create more gluten. So we're gonna let that rest, and what we're gonna do is heat up the oven to 350 Fahrenheit. So, because that's as high as it can go. Actually, you can go to like 300. And while that's heating up, we don't have a pizza pan or anything, but any flat pan will do. So I guess we're gonna use that. Let's have tomato sauce. We're gonna cut up proper tomatoes. There's some fresh basil, don't have mozzarella, so cheddar, and some grated cheese. I like doing it this way actually, because like the thing is the tomato sauces get too tomato-y. And this way, if you slice the tomatoes really thin, you get this natural look and natural flavor. So, we're gonna make two pizzas, and they're both gonna be the same. I'm not gonna like do anything special. You They're better if they're thin, sliced thinly, but I don't have the best of knives here. So when I get back to Zagreb, you know, I'll have my stuff back. That should be good for 2 pizzas. Go away food. So pizza prep, if you have the dough done, it's actually really quick. If you want, you can actually use the passata. You don't have to like cook it or boil it or anything. Boil it down. Just kind of spread it with a spoon. I like it natural. You can add like dry basil and all the spices, but I usually don't. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the dough. And this is good enough for 4 small pizzas. So we're just gonna try to separate it into quarters. It's still a little sticky, so I'm just gonna like lightly dust the counter to make it so that I can spread it out. So if you want to get that circle shape, you can like flip it, or you can just let gravity work. But if you don't want to, pizzas don't have to be circular. That's just industry standard. So I like it like that, oblong. Maybe I can make it a little bit more circular. How about that? So this works well with cornmeal, but I don't have cornmeal. So the reason why you don't want to use flour usually is if you're using a pizza oven, it's gonna burn, and it's gonna create that the bottom's gonna be a little bit bitter. But you know, this is not a pizza oven. I don't have pizza stone. So we're just gonna, it's gonna be fine. So I'm gonna just lay it out like so. There's gonna be a lot of water, so basically hopefully it won't melt. So you don't want a lot of tomatoes on there. Just spread it out as well as you can. Now we're gonna grate some cheese. And yeah, if you wanna actually block the liquid from hitting the dough, you can put a layer of cheese on there really quick. So we're just gonna redo this. Which is really sad because like it's already moist on the bottom. But let's see if this works. The oils from the cheese should make a little bit of a barrier. And if you want to, sprinkle in some of the leftover. This is leftover. This will add a little bit of salty flavor. And since you're using natural tomatoes, you can actually add some salt or pepper to taste. as Adam Ragusa goes, like, it's homogeneity is boring. Let's make it a little bit different. This will go well with slices of mozzarella, but there's no, I didn't see any low moisture mozzarella in the stores, so this will have to do. And we have some fresh basil that we'll add on after. These types of pizzas is great not to have it too cheesy. Gonna put on some capers for some zing. Not so much though. And that goes in the oven for about 15-20 minutes. Well, that turned out to be perfect.
Wow, look at that big pizza you made.
Yeah, this is like bigger.
Yep. Do you ever see a pizza that size? What? Did you?
Not.
Yes.
That big pizza.
You want some?
Would you like some pizza?
No.
Thank you. No handkerchief, thank you.
So there you go, the big piece of pizza. So this one's gonna be a little bit more special. I'm working all week until like Sunday.
Oh. Want a swap?
What?
Do you want to mind some kids mind going to the doctor stuff?
What do you mean?
You can stay at my shoes and I'll leave your job.
Sure. final presentation.
Yeah, we must put it up there.
I didn't see that you're feeding her.
We must put it up there, you see.